All right, welcome back, guys. Got a beautiful piece of coral here. This is some clear and blue. And let's get to working on it. So, where do I want to start? Now, I've already bifaced this out, obviously. So, just kind of in the what do I want to do from here stage. Now, this clear stuff can be very fragile, more fragile than the other types of coral. So it's kind of best to be a little careful. Make sure you abrade quite well. And yeah, this thing's already translucent. So just gonna turn the edge, then flake off on this side. I think that'll be the best course of action. So let's give it a shot. All right, so we got kind of a platform to run down through off of this face. See just how clear these things are. I mean, gorgeous. Separate my big flakes. So I took a big flake here, I'm gonna take another big flake here, and kind of keep that pattern. That one didn't release as good. Actually, none of these might because they're still running over this big ridge. So I probably won't get any great strikes here. But it'll kind of give me a basis to work off of. All right. So if anything, we got that square edge off, and now we got some platforms we can easily run. Now, most of our color's on this side, so I want to do my best to preserve it. So I'll try to flake off the clear side as much as I can. When I rubbed the platform, I could already tell it wasn't set up right, which is why I'll do like a rub like that before I hit. It kind of tells me if it needs more abrading or not. Sometimes it does, sometimes it does not. Pretty nice. Uh-oh. Gouged out a bit more than I wanted to there. And so that can kind of mess up my other stripes if I'm not careful. Let me go down a size here. I'll fix the symmetry. While also fixing one of the issues I made a little bit earlier. Let me go to this size. Sorry I'm not talking as much, I'm just trying to focus here. Don't need to get the tip too thin, because I can get it thin with my pressure flicker. And that'll come a little later. Honestly, most of the work that I'm looking at here can be done via pressure flicker. Okay, that's not as bad. Kind of felt worse than it sounded. Hey. Okay, I'm gonna do a little isolating. Go. So that hinge we had on the other side, we can finally say we got it. And most of the other stuff can just, like I said, be done with pressure. But for kicks and giggles, we're gonna do a little bit more percussion. There we go. And that's looking good. Thank you. Hey, Mr. Pete. All right. And with that, I think I'll switch over. Well, do I want to yet? Couple more strikes. As Pete finds his folks from the school bus. Definitely have some options. Worst comes to worst, we got a bowling double, which isn't a bad idea. Here. Yeah, I don't think a bowling's a terrible idea. There we go. Got cut a little bit. All right, so we're just making a little bevel. Pretty much all we're doing. Collector for this. Let's do the other side. I actually made a bowline in a previous video. It took me 10 minutes. It's a 10 minute long challenge. But this will kind of be a revamped, or like a bowling 2.0. Back over it, do the same kind of deal. Thank you. it's about at this stage where if I feel like I need to thin this thing out a little bit, I have, or I definitely can if I need to. In this case, I don't think I really need to. Except in like maybe one or two spots, which I'm about to take care of here. Pretty much just pushing in. Where I feel like I need to. Actually, I know I have a photo. Well, I can just use this book here. Bowling Bevel. Find which one I like. And go with one of them. style do I like the best? You have your bowling expanded notch. Now that would look pretty cool. I actually kind of like that. You have your normal bowlings coming from the sides. Maybe we'll try a bowling expanded notch. Just because, why not? It's in a bowling plane. Yeah, I may go for that. Get everything symmetrical first and foremost. There. Bill's found somebody. Pete. Hush, son. Good boy. This side a little bit. I'm gonna stop there on the notches. So I'll go a little bit further for the sake of symmetry. Okay, that will help. So we've got a preform for a bowline of some kind.
Pete.
Now, let me sharpen this thing up.
Over here, bud.
And let us do a little bit of pressing. If we can. We got a little bit of a bevel there.
What's up, Pete?
All right, let's do the same thing on the other side. Realize why I hate making bowlines, because all the pressure you gotta do. Ah, not a fan. Pete, why don't you go lay somewhere, buddy? Lay down. See what we can do here. Pete, hush. There we go. That's what I needed right there. Exactly what I needed. Hush, Pete. Don't want to mess anything up, so. Sharpen my tool, come through here. Get 'em, Pete. Still trying to figure this out. Okay, so the notches are getting there. As for the blade, we need to do a little bit more. Maybe one more solid pass will give us what we're looking for. Go lay down somewhere, buddy. Gotta finish up our point. Lay down. Looking pretty good, I'd say. Now, this is where some tedious work is gonna come in. Make sure this is nice and thin. Just gonna do a little bit of serration separation, I guess you could call it. It rhymes. I guess we can call it that. Not really doing any flake removals. I'm just kind of cleaning up in between each little serration. Now what I'm doing isn't super necessary, but I think it adds to a little bit of character in the point. So this side I just did. This side I haven't done. Can you tell the difference? This side just kind of whatever. And this side you have kind of some sharp edges. Certainly sharper than the other side. So I'm gonna go with this now. You about ready to go in, buddy? I am too. Now we gotta finish our point first. And if there aren't any serrations, you can actually make them. By just doing little sequential presses. Up and down. And around the point. Back on this side. I think it's looking pretty solid. Pretty solid. Thank you. Okay. Now for the base, let me just make sure it looks good. On this side, it looks a little bit lopsided. So I'm gonna fix it. That's looking better. Yeah, let's go with that. So there is our finished Bolin bevel, or Bolin expanded notch, whatever you want to call it. I think it's pretty. I actually really like it. It's translucent. See right through it. And I guess Pete wants to see it too. But I like that. Some good color. A little bit of blue, and nice little bowling. All right, guys, appreciate it. Hope you enjoyed, and we shall catch you on the next video. Peace.